Keep watching because coming up, I've got some tips and tricks to make you a Microsoft Outlook master. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's Tony and this is Tony Dawson Tech. In this video, we're going to look at Microsoft Outlook, which is known as a personal information manager software system, although it's more primarily used as an email client. And it's probably the biggest used email client for business and for personal use. So these five tips, if you use Outlook, will turn you into an Outlook master. But before we get into that, if this is your first time here, think about hitting that subscribe button. We're really close to 1,000 subscribers on this channel, so we'd love to get there as soon as possible. If you're a returning viewer, I love you all. Thank you very much for your support. So Microsoft Outlook then, a lot of people use it, and a lot of people use it because you don't have to just use it with Hotmail or Microsoft accounts. You can even use it with Gmail accounts. I use it both for business and personal use. And these five tips are just going to make your life easier. Now, there are loads of tips and tricks out there, so I'm not going to do them all, but there will be future videos with more as they're released and some that are quite new already. So strap yourself in. Let's go straight into tip number one. First up then, we've got dictation, which if you're not a speed typist, this could save you a lot of time by just saying what you want in your email. Once you've opened up your email on the message tab, you will see the option to dictate. I would suggest you just check in the language options in the drop-down. Make sure it's set to wherever you are, especially English. There's a difference, obviously, between United States and United Kingdom in the way we describe stuff. So it's on United Kingdom. We're good to go. If you're unsure what you can say to make this, because it's not just words, you can say punctuation marks and various stuff. If you just hover over dictate, you will see this window pop up and tell me more. On the right hand side, you will get help. Go to what can I say, and you will see there a list of what you can say and what you will get, depending on what you want to use. I'll leave that to you, but just as a quick demonstration, click on where you want to dictate to. So let's look at the subject line. Now, the dictation button is just like a record button. You press it once and it will start recording. So let's press that now. Stores list for Sunday. Bob. Comma. New line. New line. Please can you email me the stores list for Sunday's event as soon as possible. Full stop. New line. New line. Kind regards, comma, new line, Tony. And then we'll turn dictation off.
There you go, dictation. Really cool feature, saves loads of time. Next, we've got screen clipping, which allows you to take a screenshot directly into an email. Have a look at this.
Okay, so let's take a look at screen clipping. This is a really cool feature. I use screenshots a lot in emails, and to do that, take a screenshot, copy and paste into the email. This has streamlined that process significantly. First thing you need to do is make sure you are selected the body of the email. And then you would, like normal, go into insert. But from here, you will see screenshot option. If you click on that downward arrow right at the bottom there, you will see screen clipping. Now, the way screen clipping works is once you've selected that screen clipping, it will open your last used window. So make sure before you click on it, you select the window you want to clip, then go back to your email, click on that down arrow and click on screen clipping. It will then open up and then it will go cloudy like that, letting you know that you're ready to take your screenshot. Take your screenshot of what you want to take, and as soon as you let go, it will automatically insert it in your email, and you're free to go to send it whoever you want to send it to. Really cool, saves loads of time. Next up, we've got a simple one, but I always like to mention it when you can,
because dark theme has become a favourite of a lot of people because it's so much easier on the eyes, especially these days when we're spending so much time in front of a screen. To do that then, just go to File, go to Options, and in Options, under General, where you can personalise your copy of Microsoft Office, you will see the Office theme, and there your options, colourful, dark grey, black, white, or use system setting. Black is the darkest one, that's the one I use. Once you've done that, click on OK and you will have your dark theme. The other way to do it again is click to File, this time go to Office Account. This is your Office account. Underneath there, you will see your Office theme. Change it to whatever you want. Bearing in mind though, on this, when you are changing this, it's your Microsoft Office that you are changing. So when you change it to dark theme or black or whatever you choose, it will go across all your Office applications. Just bear that in mind once you choose this feature. Something I also want to note with the dark theme is in emails, even though it is on a dark theme, what you can do is, because of people format their emails differently, you can, there's an option here to switch background, and you can switch that so the actual emails appear with a white background so you can see the emails as they were intended. Little cool feature, but sometimes some things are hidden depending on how it's formatted. But there you go, easier on the eye and a simple feature.
Have you ever sent an email and the moment you hit that send button, you have regretted what you've typed? Well, our next feature allows you to delay a sent email. It can really be a lifesaver. Take a look.
So this is how you can delay your sent emails. On the home screen, on the ribbon, you will see rules. Click on rules and click on manage rules and alerts. This window will pop up. It's a rule that we are going to be creating, so click on new rule. This is the rules wizard. There's many options in here. What we're interested in is apply rule on messages I send. Click on that one and go to next. So on the rule wizard, you don't want to tick everything but you want to quarantine every email you send, especially if you've got that hot-headedness. So click on next without doing that, and it will warn you that this rule will be applied to every message you send. Is this correct? Yes, it is. You will get to this step now, and that bottom one where it says deferred delivery by a number of minutes. Click on that. At the bottom there, it's reviewing what you are selecting. Apply this rule after I send the message and defer the delivery by a number of minutes. If you click number of, this is the box you will get up. Now it's in minutes, so the minimum you can have is one, but however you want your cool off period to be, but I'm sure one is enough for most people, and click OK. You will now see it's changed to defer delivery by 1 minute. Click on next, no exceptions, click on next. You can give it a name, whatever you want. Let's call it cool down. Step two is to set up the rule options. You want to turn on this rule, and if you've got multiple email addresses that you're using in Outlook, then turn it on for create this rule on all accounts, and you would then click on finish. You get a warning saying this rule will only work in Outlook, which is pretty obvious, so click on that, click on OK. When you now create an email and you click on send, it will remain in your outbox for 1 minute. If after that 1 minute or that moment you hit send, you want to change it, just click on your outbox, double click on that email, and you can amend what you want to say or delete it before it actually gets sent. If you need to cool down, it's a really great feature.
Now the next tip is for those of us that have multiple email addresses, which I'm sure it's most of you out there. Now in Outlook, you don't just have to have Outlook and Hotmail email addresses, you can use it for Gmail as well. But the problem is when you've got all those different email addresses and mailboxes, you have to click on each one to see the inbox. This allows you to have a unified inbox so you can see all your emails in one pane. Let's take a look.
And this is Unified Inbox. At the moment, I've got 6 accounts in my Outlook. There are more that I need to add into there, but it will only show the inbox for the one I've selected. What I want to see is all my emails in one reading pane. Now, to do that, what you need to go up at the top, there's a search box. Change the current folder to all mailboxes. And then in the search term, just type in folder, colon, space, inbox. Click on enter. And what you will see there now is your inbox shows all your emails for every account appear in one pane, and you can just scroll through them. Saves time, saves clicking around, and you can see everything in one. It's a great feature.
There you go. I hope you got something from those tips and tricks. There will be more follow-up videos to this, as there are quite a lot for Outlook. If you've got a suggestion of something that you like in Outlook and you want to share it with the viewers, then let me know in the comments and I'll include it in a future video. If you like that, please give me a like. It really does help the algorithm and it tells YouTube you've enjoyed what you're watching and you want to see some more. If you want to support me in other ways, you can buy me a coffee at coffee.com. The link's in the description. But for now, if you haven't subscribed, the link's up here. And here's another couple of videos if you want to carry on watching. Until next week, guys. See you later.